This video will show you how to store, manage, and cite bibliographic references using Zotero, a free reference management app. Learning to use Zotero will save you time with your research projects. Zotero allows you to store all your citation information and PDFs in one place so you can read and reference them whenever you want. Zotero will also auto-generate all your in-text citations and a formatted bibliography for your research projects. Zotero is a powerful tool. With so many features, it can feel intimidating at first to learn this new app. This video will help you get started. There are two versions of Zotero, a downloadable desktop version and a web-based version. In this video, we will only cover the web-based version. To create your free account, begin by going to zotero.org. At the top right of the page, select Login. At the login page, you'll be prompted to register for a free account. Enter a username, email, and password that you'd like to be linked to Zotero. It does not have to be your Wayne State email or access ID. Then select Register. You will be sent an email with a link to activate your new account. Once activated, you will be sent to a page titled Zotero Syncing. The information on this page pertains to the desktop version of Zotero and is not relevant for the web-based version. Instead, navigate to the link Download in the upper right corner of the page. On the Download page, you will see an option to download the Zotero connector. The Zotero connector is a browser extension that imports information directly into the app. The connector should automatically detect your browser. Choose Install Connector. Follow the prompts to complete installation. When installation is complete, choose the puzzle piece icon in your browser bar to pin the Zotero connector to your toolbar. Now you're ready to go! On the Zotero page, go to Web Library. Your library is where all your sources are stored. The icons on the left-hand side of the list identify the kinds of resources in your library, such as journal articles, web pages, or books. The right-hand columns provide more information about each item. To customize the right-hand columns, select the Column Selector icon. Here you can add or subtract columns from your view. There is a search bar at the top of the page. Use this to search for known items in your library. For example, when I search social work, all of my sources related to social work appear. When you select a particular item in your library, information about that item will auto-populate on the right-hand side of the page. As you review the data, you can edit each field to fix any possible mistakes or add in any missing information. For example, if you plan to use APA-style citations, you may need to change the title field to sentence case. On the Notes tab, you can add a note about the item. For example, I might add a note that says, "Will use for 2023 term paper." The Tags tab will auto-populate with subject terms related to the item. You can add additional tags, either about the content of the item or how you plan to reference it. Here, I'm going to add a tag that says 2023 term paper. If the item includes an attachment, such as a full-text PDF, it will appear in the Attachments tab. If nothing automatically attached in the importing process, you could manually add a link or file. On the left-hand side of the page are collections. Collections are an organizational tool which allows you to sort your sources into folders. These folders could be arranged based on subject, courses, or specific projects. For example, I've organized my collections by semester, course, and assignment. To add a new collection, hover your cursor over My Library, then select the plus sign. I will add an example folder. To add items into a collection, first select an item in your library. Then select the Add to Collection icon in the banner at the top of the page. Alternatively, you can also click and drag items into your collections. Individual items can be added to multiple collections. To remove an item from a collection, select the Remove from Collection icon. It's important to note that you should not select the Trash icon, as this will delete the item from your library entirely. My Library will always include all of the citations you have saved to Zotero. Now let's learn how to import items into your Zotero library. Most of the time, you'll want to add your sources directly from the web. Let's start by looking at a web page resource. Here is an article from The Atlantic that I'd like to add to my library. Since I've downloaded the Zotero plugin, I can just click the Zotero icon in my browser bar, and the web page will be automatically saved to my Zotero library. Sometimes the information is not perfect. When Zotero adds a citation, it looks for the metadata, the electronic information buried in the web page or PDF, to populate the fields. You may need to enter some information manually or make corrections if the imported information is incorrect. When conducting research projects, you're likely to be looking for scholarly and peer-reviewed articles in a library database. Next, let's review how to import sources from a database. Here is a results page from a search in Summon. I can already see that I would like to use several of these results for my research. When I select the Zotero extension icon, it prompts me to choose which items I'd like to add to my library. This is an easy way to do a bulk import. On the other hand, let's say I was only interested in the first item on the results page. Once I navigate to that article, I can once again select the Zotero extension icon to save the article, with a full-text PDF, to my Zotero library. A final option is to add items manually. Click on the plus sign in the banner at the top of My Library to manually type in metadata about the item you wish to cite. Now that you can add sources to your library and create collections for your research projects, let's learn how to use Zotero to create citations. To create an in-text citation, select the item in your library and then select the Create Citations icon from the banner at the top of the page. A new window will pop up, prompting you to choose your preferred citation style. Once you've made your selection, you can simply copy the citation to your clipboard and paste it into your document. To create a bibliography for the end of your paper, start by selecting all of the items you've cited in your work. Then select the Create Bibliography icon from the banner at the top of the page. Again, you will be prompted to select your preferred citation style. Notice that the bibliography is already alphabetized and includes hanging indents. Simply copy to your clipboard and paste it into your paper. Note that it's important to review both your in-text citations and bibliography to check for mistakes. Zotero is a helpful tool, but you are ultimately responsible for the accuracy of your work. If you are unclear about the rules for citations, check out the MLA, APA, and Chicago Citation Style Guides on the library website. This video has provided an overview of basic Zotero functions. As you get used to the interface, you may want to explore more features. For example, Zotero allows you to share resources with others through group libraries. The downloadable version of Zotero has additional advantages, like the ability to embed citations directly as you write using Word or Google Docs. If you're interested in learning more about what Zotero can do for you, check out the Zotero Resource Guide at guides.lib.wayne.edu/Zotero. Still need help? Librarians are available via chat, email, phone, or by appointment.